Is film production, becoming a producer, somebody who can actually translate scripts into films, something that you plan to do in the future? I mean, even if films
I
don't
do.
actually feature you.
I do. I do. Again, never say never because I never thought I'd be, have my own startup, be a founder someday. So similarly with producing, I started off by saying no, it's too much, but you never know. I think it is definitely something I'm very, very excited to tell stories, be a part of stories, and if there are, like you said, even films that I may not feature in, but it's a film that I believe in and I can help put it together and actually produce it. I'd love to do that, for sure.
Okay. Is there any film you've seen recently which you like felt, wow, this is something that I would have probably loved to back? A show or a feature film?
There's been so much content right now because it's like, we're just like consuming
Something
content
that really hit home with you.
so often. I think a show like Scam, it's a fantastic show and a story which is like just like from the heart of, our country. So I really like it when I found it fabulous. And I'm still getting through it. I've not reached the end, so don't give me any spoilers. But it's just got my attention all the way. I would, and even content like Patal Lok, that is actually produced by my dear friend Anushka, and I also messaged her like for it, and I posted about it also. I think she's fabulous to be, producing. She's actually producing so much content. Just through the lockdown, we saw two of her,
Right,
produced
Bulbul.
contents come up, Bulbul and that. So, and I watched both, and they were both really fabulous. It made me feel very inspired. So yeah, like these, I'm just naming a couple of there. There must be so many things that I haven't seen, so I don't want to just like take names and offend anyone else. But content right now is just like it's crossed so many boundaries, especially because of the digital world. So it's pretty exciting as to what you can do. So my eye is like out there now, just looking content to produce.
Now, Alia, my last question is, and I'm sure a lot of fans will want to ask you this, what are we seeing you in next? There's RRR and there's Brahmastra, of course. So which one of them will it be and when?
There's RRR, there's Brahmastra, there's Gangubai. Now, these are three films that I'm rushing to the finish line to finish. So which is why all my time is right now. I've been shooting since September. I've been shooting for Gangubai. We've been shooting nights, so it's just like kind of nonstop. I will be going to RRR soon, joining the team, and extremely excited about that. I've been working on my Telugu since quite some time now, so I just can't wait to go and just speak all my lines and get it done with. Hope I'm not a disappointment, but I work very hard on that. And of course, there is Brahmastra, but honestly, right now we're all waiting for some sort of clarity for the theaters. I think everybody just needs, we're all waiting with fingers crossed that hopefully things get better soon, and when it's extremely safe and we encourage people to come back to the theaters with good cinema, and our cinemas can be up and thriving again, because I think we're all just really waiting for that day. So those are the three films that I have to finish. So that's my lineup, and then I have a couple of more films that I'm like going to be going into, which I can't say yet.
Okay, just want to ask. I'm a South Indian, and I find Telugu the most difficult. I mean, I'm from Kerala. I'm a Malayali, but I find Telugu language the most difficult to understand and speak. How did you manage to learn? And did you? How much could you learn?
So there's this one scene where I'm just speaking so much. So I was like, listen, the rest I'll manage, because I know that eventually, even while I'm there, I have an elephant's memory. I can remember it 2 days before. But this one particular scene, I said, I have to master it. Like, I should be saying it in my sleep. So how I did it, I don't know. I'm going to go and find out if I'm actually doing it correctly. Once I'm there, I think I'll know. But my coach who's been helping me, he's been quite encouraging. And now he's reached the word where he said, "Very nice, ma'am." So I think I've reached that point where I've said it correctly a couple of times. It's actually not, I found it difficult in the beginning because it was alien sounds. But once I identified, you know, they give me the explanation, the meaning, how it is in Hindi, in English and all of that. Once I identified my emotions to it, it kind of started flowing very, very beautifully. And I think it's such an intricate, interesting language, Telugu, because what we take 6 words to say, they, you know, you can say in Telugu in 3 words or 2 words even sometimes. And I find that so fascinating. I just hope that, you know, the audience is accepting of my language.
Thank you so much for talking to us, Alia, and all the best for your new venture.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.